Okay, and welcome to the demonstration for basic automation using the Steve's Factory Manager. I've set up some inventories here for the system to look at, and we're going to craft some shears real quick. So up here, I've already put some iron in here. So we're gonna down here, these guys are empty at the moment. I left those attached just so we can see the inventories that are connected. Now, the first thing you need is a trigger. The trigger can tell the system to do something based on a redstone signal or an interval. And because I don't need things, at least this thing, super fast, I'm going to set it to 5 seconds so we don't have a lot of extra processing going on that isn't really needed. So it's going to check and try to run this every 5 seconds. I like to name these so that I know what it is it's supposed to be doing, and I know that that's the input, or that's the trigger. The input tells the system where to get the items it's going to use, and you can stack multiple inputs together to make fairly complex things, but we'll get to that. So I know that this is where the chest is with the iron in it. You kind of have to know where things are at, but if you lay them out straight like I did, you can also tell that where things are based on how far away from the controller they are. So that's kind of why I set it up in a big long line like that. So let's name this. We're going to name it Get Iron. We've selected our inventory, and then we have to tell it what side of the inventory to get it now, get it from. Now this is, it took me a little while to figure this out, this is related to where, as if you're the, imagine you're the chest standing on that, the direction that the cable is down on that. So the input target is going to be down. And you can select north, south, east, west, up, down. So once you kind of get an idea of where things are connecting, you can do that. Now we're going to whitelist because we only want iron. Iron, iron ingots. So it's going to get iron ingots. And then if I right click, we're going to specify the amount, and we're going to get two. So there's that. So there's our input. And then down here, the little thing that looks like the crafting table is the crafter. And so we're going to, make shears, the crafting. You imagine that this is the crafting bench. So you click iron. Oh, nope, we're still up there. Shears. I didn't save that. Iron. Oh, come on. There we go. One iron there. And one iron there. And the side over here will show you what the output is going to be. So if you've got the recipe wrong, this will be blank. Now the system will not do anything unless you tell it where the excess inventory is. And this confused me a little bit, but if I just start with pretty much any character, chest or a space or something like that, it will search through the things that you have connected. And so we're going to put excess inventory back in the same chest. Okay? And that's just, it wants to know where to put things it didn't need for the crafting. I think it also sort of assumes that maybe some of the things you used to craft are going to be returned to you, like if you're crafting sandwiches, you get your cutting board back, so it needs to know where to put that. And then we need to tell it where to go, so we get an output. And this, get the output, the inventories, and I want to put it to one of these drying racks. And I'm going to tell the target. Now, the drying rack doesn't seem to have a direction necessarily associated with it, so I've managed to do, I think down should work for us. And then the items, we are going to whitelist, because we only want shears, and we only want one shear ever on that. And then we can close that up. Oops. And then we would change that to put on rack. So there's our commands. And then the only thing we have to do now, I'll step back for a second here. We still have our four iron here. We have our empty drying racks. But when I come through and click, 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 connect all those up, I have shears. And it's used up two iron. Now, I only put two iron there because I wanted to show if I take these shears. So I've been wandering around. I realize I need more, or I've got a lot of leaves, or I need more water, so I need to go get leaves. I can come over here. I can grab the shears. I can use them to my heart's content and not worry about it. And magically, there's more shears right there. Just waiting for the next time I need to do this. And the only thing I need to do to make sure that this all works is to put iron in that chest. So there you go. Simple, easy way to do some shears, and a very simple way to do some crafting, some auto crafting. And there's one other thing here. If I create a command group, I think, drag these guys into here. I haven't tried this part yet, but supposedly I can do drop commands here. Now are they? No. I'm going to have to play with that part of it to figure out how to use that. But for now, I'll just take my commands and put them off to the side so that we have room for our next piece. And our next piece, I'm going to get some stuff ready over here, and I'll be right back. We're going to be doing sandwiches next. Okay?